name is Gerard Riley. I'm here with Malcolm White, Irish Balloon Flights. We decided to do a video of the town from the outskirts in, from Scullockstown Business Park, where we are now. We're just leaving Scullockstown Business Park at the moment. It was built in the boom years of 2006 to 2008. It's only about a quarter full at the moment. In 50 years time, who knows, it could be part of Dublin or the outskirts of Dublin. It could be a booming industrial station. We're now entering the Trim Dublin Road, heading back into Trim. Left hand side you have Jack Quinn's pub. Jack was the captain. Jack was played on the 1967 All-Ireland football team that won. The original recording of on YouTube, 1989, was done by a man by Christy Dalton, and I think one of his sons or children drove in this road and videotaped it. And his home place where he was born and raised is on the left hand side now. And Pat Murphy live there now, with all their children who have moved on at this stage. The house is just there on the left, the pink house. Garage on your left hand side, 154.9 cents per litre of petrol.
The Topaz Garage was a Texaco garage until last year, and in the 1989 video it's a Texaco garage then as well.
Left hand side is the entrance into Knightsbrook Golf Hotel and Resort. And when was the original tape done coming in this road?
1989, yeah. And 1991.
Okay, two tapes. There's a right hand turn here down to Marshall Regan. It's a nice Trim Tidy Towns, Trim. Left hand side you have St. John's Estate. You can get a view of the castle as you drive into Trim. Yellow steeple. The Poetry Fields, which is owned by the people of Trim.
There was a big huge tree here until about 3 years ago that was knocked down by a storm. That's in the original videos.
All the housing estates, Alan Mackin's house on the right, Don Baker's house. Don Baker, a famous singer, is living on the right hand side there. Dillon Court, Castle Close. Barbara Donnelly's house, Gibney's house. Left into Knightsbrook Estate. Sorry, Effernock Manor. David and Linda O'Brien's house on your left. Beautiful drive into Trim on a summer's evening. Boyne Community School is on the left, was originally the Christian Brothers, where I went to school back in the 70s. Statue of Our Lady of Trim. John McAvoy's house on the left, where Tyrrell used to live, old family used to live in Trim. Heading straight down towards the castle on your right hand side, you have the famous Donkeys of Trim. Buns, biscuits, raisins, nuts, puddings, crumbs, muffin, brownie, and mini. And our great castle. Trim Castle Hotel. Great asset to the town here in the middle of Trim. Castle Street with the beautiful flowers, beautiful houses. And we'll come up to where that you can see the red barriers where the capsule is going to be put down. On Friday night, two nights away. Cormac's. Entering onto Market Street now from Castle Street. Courthouse, Paddy Powers. It was a supermarket originally one time. Then it was Rogan's Drapery. There was Riley's Drapery back in 1910. The old Abbey Lodge, in the original video in 1989, my red Peugeot was outside the door there. Did you know that, Basil?
Yeah.
John Spicer's closed up, used to employ 80 to 100 people making breads. My grandfather's practice, Daniel J. Riley, company solicitors. We're onto Emma Street now. Paddy Melia's taxi on the right hand side. Paddy Melia just waving to us. Left hand side, lovely old house, Dermot and Charlotte Bulger's house. Siri Riley, my godfather was a councillor that lived there. Wellington Monument on your right has survived there for many, many years. This is where all the old factories were originally, used to employ hundreds of people. Trimproof was the original factory there. Castle Arch Hotel, originally the Wellington Court Hotel. Council offices on the right hand side. Mornington House. Before it was council office, it was actually Atlantic 252 radio station. Had their station here, even though it was broadcast all over England. Everyone in England thought it was in London, it was actually in Trim. And all the DJs used to fly in every Monday morning. This is where we've had our council meetings for the past 8 years, I'd say. Before that, we were on Mill Street, and then my first council meeting in 2009 was in the Town Hall in Trim, upstairs in the Town Hall in Trim. The original table is still in the Mornington House here. On your right, Megan Quinn, actually I was talking to her the other day, she's putting something into the capsule. some drawings into the capsule. She did a lot of murals around the town. Great artist. They come to the roundabout, which exits from Longwood, Summer Hill, and we're back in the Ring Road at the Trim. All the lovely plants. Flower beds are out now for the Tidy Towns. The first judging will be in probably 1 week's time. So all the staff of the Town Council and Brian Heffernan and his great crew are out doing all the work. We've won 4 bronze, 2 silvers, I think, and we're hoping for our first gold in 2014. So we intend to put one of the bronze medals into the capsule on Friday night. On the right hand side is where the new folk park is supposed to go. Fire station on the left. Highfield bed and breakfast on the left. It used to be the old maternity. My mother delivered many a baby in there back in the 60s. Dr. Eileen Riley. The hall in St. Mary's School is named after her. Geraldine and Eddie Degnan run that Highfield House very successfully. We're on the Ring Road now, which is going right through Poachy Fields, splits the field. Beautiful walk on the right hand side, right along the boy. Right down to Newton and back in again. One of the greatest assets of the town, having so many over 100 acres of land just lying there for the people of Trim to use. Here's one of the Tidy Towns people out painting. Poachy Field was used for, we had two hot air balloon festivals here a few years ago. That right, Malcolm?
Yeah, 2010, 2012. 2010, we attracted 75,000 visitors to the town and caused a fair bit of mayhem with 5 to 10 mile queues all the way into the town. But the weather wasn't that cooperative, but despite that, everyone had a great time.
It was the type of balloon, it was the...
Special shapes, yeah.
Special shapes.
Weird and wonderful shapes. Hot air balloons that were shaped like rabbits, and there were all different sorts of shapes. Sonic the Hedgehog, who was a famous cartoon character during the 2000s, 2000 to 2010.
And of course the bees, the 2 bees balloons.
Yeah, some balloons came over from America and Belgium, Holland, from a number of different countries. So it was a multinational event.
Back in the days, we had a lot of energy in those days.
But then Trim has always been the hot air ballooning capital of Ireland. There's more ballooning taking place in this county than there is anywhere else in the country. Okay, into Navengate.
James O'Shea's house on the right. Ran for election last week, just barely missed getting a seat. Ran for the Labour Party. Has been a councillor with me for 5 years. Excellent man. And Tony's Bookshop. Peter Callan and the Style. Here we have Leanin's Pub, famous pub. One of the best pubs on the East Coast. James Griffin has written over the door. Tommy Leanin runs that now. Michael Leanin's father was a councillor with me for many years. We're on High Street now, lovely old buildings. Regan McEntee, Ulster Bank, Heffernan's. Brian Heffernan's. Here at the library. And St. Patrick's School is now a little creche, beautiful creche. Mill Street, on the left-hand side, second building on the left. We used to have our council meetings. Still, a building still owned by the Meath County Council. Turning up Lower Mill Street. Once called Scarlet Street. There's a well on your left-hand side with glass cover. Sarsfield Avenue on the left. Great old trim families live along here in this Lowman Street. Trevor Golden's family home there. Another councillor. The church on the right, and the school, St. Patrick's School, on the left. Priory. It's amazing since the video was taken in 1989, the amount of pubs have closed and trimmed.
Yeah, it's amazing. That's a big change.
Super Value, Suhans, Tobin's News Agent, O'Shaughnessy's Pharmacy, Fox's Fruit and Veg, Haggard Street now. One-way system trim a few years ago has changed the town so people can get around it much easier. Ted Mortis, second generation, third generation working along there. Brogan's, which is another place, another pub closed. Families on the right. Family houses, Griffin Park on the left. Norma Davis in the corner site there. Remember when all these lands were all agricultural lands? Not that long ago, Lackanash on the right. Hamilton Place. Clunery, all the farmland on the left hand side, Buckley's, Joe McNally, Goulding's, Times is on the right. You see the little houses there. They're getting ready for the all part of the Scullerstown Festival. They have the High Nelly on Friday night, but they're not going to make it to the capsule because they're going to be too late. They won't arrive in Trimpton around 9 o'clock. We're now in
Meath Motor Park. built a... like Skurdox Down, there's empty units here which are yet to be developed. Supermax, a favourite drive-through food outlet for people.
Cranian's beautiful furniture and bedding, Anthony and Joanne. Ratnally Road to the left. We're in Newtown now. Anne-Marie, Collie and Jerry's house. Lee McMiniman. Mary Donnelly is still working away there with her horses and donkeys. And Mary Donnelly. This is Donnelly, as I call her. PW Works building on the left, Alfco on the left, and then down to Marsh's pub, ancient pub, one of the oldest pubs in Ireland, with the old bridge and Newtown graveyard on the right. Getting into the car, old friend of mine, known for years, brother-in-law Johnny Blythe and Robin McLaughlin, goes down for a bit of chat every evening. Patrick Street. Lovely. St. Joseph's Hospital to the left. The old weighing bridge is there to your right. They used to weigh all the lorries that were going on the roads by the council. Skullware on the right. Catholic Church. St. Mary's, St. Michael's on the left. There's the old convent school on the right. Then we have the... and Leonard's on the left. New Haggard Road. Club. You have the graveyard, St. Norman's graveyard on your left, the Trim Sports and Leisure Centre, built a few years ago, a beautiful swimming pool and leisure centre. Trim GA on the right, fantastic huge building, great facilities. the Gallops on the right. Just they've started to build houses there again. They've lain idle there for 6 years during our recession, which has lasted from 2007. 2008 to now 2014. It's interesting. There were 10 vans and cars down in Knightsbrook last week in an area doing up houses.
Yeah.
For, again, like houses that were lying idle for,
yeah.
You know. Isn't it great to see?
It is.
Heading down Watergate Street from Emmett Street. All cautious on the left. Mrs. Wall lives there on the left hand side. Cavanagh's Garage. Look at the murals on the wall. The new site for Aldi, hopefully. Boyne Valley Activities on the right hand side and the Canoeing Club. Old part of town here. Opinions over the left hand side. Lovely to see all the flowers. Tidy towns. It's amazing the difference in a week with the flowers out. Look at the cottages here with the flowers, the different colours. St. Mary's Abbey over on the left. Peter and Marie Higgins and family live over there. Looking over back into Francini's restaurant. Gulliver's and the Ace Domestics. That's the entrance into the castle, and we're back to where the capsule will be going down Friday evening. Up at Cashlan and the tourist office and the old town hall.